Ranos here, and welcome to episode of Space Engineers. This episode takes a look at the half-block light panel by Jethor, as well as an update, which came out a long time ago, of the P.O.M. XL blocks by Shadester. Yeah, that update came out around, I think it was about 14 days after the actual release, back in March. Yeah, I missed it. Anyway, why don't we head out and take a look at the light? This is a very simple mod. So, first person, wrong button. Here we go. So the half panel, well, half block light panel. It looks quite on it. Yeah. It's basically the light panel block that you get with one of the DLC packs, attached to the bottom of a squished interior block cube. So we can fit in the space like this. Because I have had several builds where I have a half block at the top of the room, but I'm unable to place any lights because there are none that fit there. However, this mod fixes that. It's quite handy. Very useful. And there we go. See, it just has a basic floor panel here, which does mesh up well with my random. And this one, I can see it uses the same block. Although, I think I might need some new shapes for these ones. So yeah, see, it does mesh together, so you can use it as part of a floor for the next floor up as well. Too bad. As for its build cost, it's 15 construction components and 16 interior plates. It's really cheap. Huh. Anyway, let's search a new light. Then we scroll down. You'll see it has a ridiculous range too. Why do you need 150 meters on this? You could just use this thing to light up the entire place. Ah. Oh well. So yeah, it has extreme range, pretty cheap to make, and is quite helpful for providing light to a variety of different builds where you would normally not be able to put one. It also allows the floor to be free. So yeah, that's that. Not really much else to say about it. Just a half block light. Speaking of half blocks, how about we move on to the XL? I'm not sure what exactly has changed, but this block has been updated. Which is a pretty convenient road. I think this was here originally. I'd have to go back and check the original video. But yeah, you can actually create a road inside your ships using these. Well, ships, stations, or whatever else. Using these incredibly large blocks. Oh yeah. There's no turn or corners. Oh well, never mind. Anyway, here we basically have a slab. That's it. It's just a pretty big slab. Half the size of all the others. Thus being a 2.5 blocks tall. You know, since they're all 5x5x5. Then you got this little corner piece, which is also 2.5 upwards and 2.5 that way. You have 5 blocks across. And then you have all of the other ramp type blocks, or the 2-piece ramp type blocks, all available as well. Thus, you can create some pretty huge builds with these. In fact, using these to make your big builds is actually making it a lot easier. Especially now that there are more types of blocks available. Unless you want any, like, fine details or anything. And, you know, these will work pretty well. Especially considering this only takes up to 2.5 blocks tall rather than all 5. Which I guess makes some builds a bit more interesting. Especially if you decide to put 2 of them close together. Yeah, like that. Okay, some sort of funnel thing. Yeah. Hey, so yeah, they're just pretty much giant blocks, which cost quite a bit to build. As you can see, needing 1,250 steel plates and 40 girders. This one won't be as much. At only 625 steel plates and 24 girders. This one's 1,000 steel plates and 24 girders. This one's only 375 steel plates and 12 girders. What about you? You'll be a lot on you. 2,225 steel plates and 48 girders. And you? 1,500 steel plates and 40 girders. Expensive. 1,875 steel plates and 40 girders. Wait, why do you cost more than that one? Huh. And this one is 625 steel plates and 32 girders. I do believe their cost was based on equivalent mass of light blocks. I think. I could be completely wrong. But yeah, they are pretty huge. Very helpful. Boing! Me. Pretty big blocks jump ever did. But yeah, that's all I can really say about them. Also, because of their large resource count, they have incredibly high integrity. Yeah, I think the integrity is actually tied to the materials, or the amount of resources used to build them. Think, I'm not 100% certain. Anyway. There's not really a lot else to say about these things. They're just, you know, that one's just the lights. And these ones are just blocks. Really big ones. So I guess I should end this one here. There'll be links for both mods down in the description below, so you can use these fancy little lights to help light up your hallways. And you can use these big giga blocks to build your giant bases, with you while providing little performance hindrance. Something. Yeah. So anyway, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you have, please leave a like and even subscribe episodes. And I shall see you all next time. Bye-bye.